Hello students, today I'll discuss about refrigerator and heat pump. The working of the refrigerator is just opposite of heat engine. So we can say the refrigerator is a device which is operating in a cycle which maintains the body at lower temperature than the temperature of atmosphere or temperature of surrounding. Here we are considering this diagram is the perfect example of the working of refrigerator. Let us consider a body A which is maintained at temperature T2. Here in this diagram, this is a body which is maintained at temperature T2, and the temperature of body A is less than the temperature of the atmosphere. Here we are considering the temperature of atmosphere is T1, so we are considering T1 is greater than T2. Now if we consider this body A is insulated, but apart from that, there is always some heat Q2 is absorbed by this body A from the atmosphere. So in that case, if the body A is absorbing heat Q2 from the atmosphere, so in that case, it will increase the temperature of this body A, or it will increase the temperature T2. So to maintain this temperature T2 of the body A, so in that case, that heat has to be removed from the body A. So this heat Q2 is absorbed by the working fluid, which is called the refrigerant. Here you can see in this diagram, this heat Q is absorbed by the working fluid, that is called the refrigerant, which evaporate in evaporator. This heat is going to the evaporator, and this heat Q2 is transferring to the refrigerant, and that refrigerant is evaporate in this device evaporator. And the refrigerant which evaporate in evaporator at a particular temperature is lower than T2 because of absorbing the latent heat of vaporization from body A in this process 4-1. This is the process 4-1. So and then the vapor goes to the compressor, and it is compressed in the compressor C1. From evaporator it goes to the compressor, and it compressed in compressor C1, which absorb the work WC. During compression, it absorb the work WC. This process is showing by process 1-2, and then after compressing this refrigerant, or after compression process, this fluid goes to the condenser, and it condensate in the particular device, a condenser C2. This condenser is C2, and which reject the latent heat of condensation Q1. After condensation, it will reject the latent heat of condensation Q1 at temperature higher than the T1 for heat transfer take place. Then after condensation, that condensate is going to the expander, and it expand in this expander adiabatically and produce the work WE. Here you can see the fluid will expand, and it will produce the work WE, and this process is shown by process 3-4. When the temperature drop to value lower than the T2, so that the heat Q2 will transfer, or the heat Q2 will flow from the body, will flow from body A to make the refrigerant evaporate. And this specific cycle, you can see here, this specific cycle, E1, C1, C2 and E2 is making the device refrigerator. This process is shown as the device or the working of refrigerator. This diagram is representing the complete process of the refrigerator. Here from body A, which is at temperature T2, will transfer the heat Q2 to the refrigerant. Then that refrigerant will pass through four processes E1, C1, C2 and E2 from evaporator, from compressor, from condenser and then expander. Then again it will transfer to the evaporator and it will absorb work. The compressor will absorb some work WC and the E2, the expander will reject the work WE and it will produce the work WE. Then the rejected heat Q1 will transfer to the atmosphere, which is at the temperature T1. So this is the complete cycle of refrigerator, and there is also a performance parameter in this refrigeration cycle. This performance parameter is called COP, and the COP is coefficient of performance. Coefficient of performance, COP, is the performance parameter of the refrigeration cycle, and the COP means what we require from the system. COP meaning the requirement which we require or what we require from the system. So the COP is defined by the ratio of desired effect of the refrigerator divided by work input. Work input. So this desired effect will denoted by the Q2 from body A, and the work input if we define by the W. So this will be Q2 divided by W, and this will be Q2 divided by Q1 minus Q2. So the COP is defined by this formula, Q2 divided by Q1 minus Q2. Next device which I'm going to discuss is the heat pump. The working of heat pump is similar to the refrigerator. The difference is only in temperature. So here if we consider a body B at higher temperature, then the temperature of the surrounding, here we are considering body A which is at higher temperature, then the temperature of the surrounding. So because of this temperature difference, there will be heat transfer to the surrounding. Then the body will maintained at constant temperature T1, and the heat extracted from the lower temperature, which is the temperature of atmosphere, and it discharged to higher temperature of body B with expenditure of work W in cyclic device. Here the difference is only this diagram is showing the working of the heat pump or the cycle of the heat pump. It is just similar to the refrigerator, but here the difference is the temperature of the atmosphere is lower than the temperature of the body which is receiving the extracted heat. The cycle is same here. And the temperature of the atmosphere is at, if we considering the temperature of atmosphere is T2, which is lower than the temperature of the body. So the heat will extract, the Q2 will extract from the atmosphere. Then it will transfer to all these four processes, evaporator, compressor, condenser, expander. From process 1, 2, 3, 4, the refrigerant will pass through all these four processes and it will produce some work. Then the heat will reject The rejected heat Q1 will transfer to the body which is at higher temperature, or the temperature of the body is higher than the temperature of the atmosphere. So this is the working of the heat pump. Heat pump is work on the cyclic process. So a working fluid is operating in all four devices, evaporator, compressor. The cycle is same. It will operating in all four processes, evaporator E1, compressor C1, condenser C2, and the expander E2. So the process is same, E1, C1, C2, E2. But here the main focus is on Q1. Here our desired effect is Q1. In refrigerator, the desired effect was the Q2. This is the desired effect for heat pump. So the coefficient of performance of the COP of heat pump will be Q1 by W, and the COP of heat pump will be, the formula for COP of heat pump will be Q1 divided by Q1 minus Q2. So here Q1 is greater than W. So here we can write here COP is always greater than 1, because Q1 is always greater than W. So COP of heat pump or COP of refrigerator is always greater than 1. So here we can write as COP of heat pump equal to 1 plus COP of refrigerator, because Q1 is also greater than Q2. So here according to this formula, COP of heat pump, we can write here Q1 equal to COP of heat pump into W. This is the formula, as per the formula of COP of heat pump, and we can write here as COP of COP of refrigerator, COP of refrigerator plus 1 into W equal to Q1. This can be a formula for Q1. This was all about the heat pump and the refrigerator. Now I'm going to discuss here a very small topic, that is equivalence of Kelvin-Planck and the Clausius statement. These two statements, the Kelvin-Planck statement and the Clausius statement, are different, but these two statements will be proved equivalent by showing the violation of one statement implies the violation of second statement, and vice versa also. This is the diagram, and through this diagram I'll explain the equivalence of Kelvin-Planck and the Clausius statement. Here let us consider a heat pump. Here you can see in this diagram there is a heat pump which transfer the heat from Q2 from the cold reservoir, which is at temperature T2, to hot reservoir. It is transferring heat Q1 to hot reservoir, which is at temperature T1, with no work done. Here W is zero, with no work done on the system. So this condition is violating the Clausius statement. Here this is the first condition which is violating the Clausius statement. Similarly, if we consider a cyclic heat engine which transfer the heat from the hot reservoir, here you can see this heat engine, cyclic heat engine, is transferring the heat Q1 from the hot reservoir, which is at temperature T1, to cold reservoir. The amount of heat is Q2 to cold reservoir, which is at temperature T2, by producing some net work done. Here W net is the net work done, so it will be Q1 minus Q2. So here we can say the amount of heat drawn from the hot reservoir this is the Q1, the amount of heat drawn from the hot reservoir is Q1, which is equal to the heat discharge by the heat pump. Here you can see this amount of heat discharge by the heat pump is equal to the amount of heat transferring to the heat engine. So here we can say, if we eliminate this hot reservoir from here, if we eliminate the hot reservoir, so the heat extracted from the heat pump will directly transfer to the heat engine. If we remove this hot reservoir, so the heat rejected by the heat pump will directly transfer to the heat engine, so that in this condition the heat pump and heat engine is working together and producing the net work done. It is producing the net work done, W net, and it's working on single reservoir. Here it is working on single heat reservoir, which is at temperature T2. So this is violating the Calvin Planck statement. So this is the condition of equivalence of Calvin Planck and the Clausius statement. This first condition is violating this Clausius statement, and if we remove this hot reservoir, so this condition is violating the Calvin Planck statement. So in that, in this condition, we can say this is the condition of equivalence of Calvin Planck and the Clausius statement. Thanks for watching the video and subscribe the channel for more lectures.